Inktober Day 14. Woo! I still love Inktober, and I hope you guys are having fun as well. We're almost halfway through the month. I can't believe it, and been having so much fun. First of all, a little update for you guys who have seen my Pacific Rim 2 video, the Gypsy Adventure that I did a couple days ago. My buddy ZH Comic Art, he actually has his version, his part of the collab that is up on his channel right now. So go check that out. I'll put a card up here. Go check out that video. He's drawing. He drew this totally amazing kaiju, okay? So go check that out on his channel right now. Just to let you guys know, I am getting this colored. So I'm having a friend color help me color this, and then I'm gonna matte paint a background. It's gonna be so sweet to actually see both of these together. So look out for that video within the next week, I'm hoping. But in the meantime, Inktober is still here, and now I'm going to start doing some characters I haven't really drawn before on my channel. Well, this character I have drawn before. I did it for my, I believe it was the 10,000. Was it the 10,000 or the 15,000? Or the 20,000. I think it was the 20,000. Sorry. The 20,000 subscriber party, and it was Rocket Raccoon, and I wanted to draw him again. I thought it would be a lot of fun to do. So why don't we watch him? Watch him. Watch me. Draw Rocket Raccoon right now. Okay, here is me drawing Rocket Raccoon, and just for a little change of pace, I wanted to give my thoughts on me drawing this character. A lot of fun to do this character because he's different. Of course, the proportions are different because he's a lot smaller. I approach the proportions like he's, you know, he's more like a teenager or a kid in terms of proportion itself. But one of the biggest challenges, of course, was drawing his fur, getting that to work well with the lighting, and this particular costume I'm doing here. This is pretty much from Guardians of the Galaxy 2, which I loved. I had a lot of fun with that particular movie, and one thing I love about Rocket Raccoon is he always has these giant mech-like guns that I really, really enjoyed drawing. Can't wait to see what kind of guns he'll have in Infinity War, but this was a lot of fun to do. As you can tell, I freehanded most of this. Like, I pulled out the French curve, which is that blue thing that you see. I use a little bit of that. And then, of course, the shadow, always trying to find the medium. Where is that level? What's too much? But had a lot of fun doing it. He's, you know, he's simple but complicated, if that makes any sense. But I had a lot of fun drawing Rocket Raccoon. And for all of you, I hope you enjoyed that. And here he is. So there you have it. That is me drawing Rocket Raccoon. Thank you so much. That was a lot of fun. So I'll tell you what, for tomorrow's video, okay, let's keep in the Avengers Infinity War theme. Why don't you let me know in the comments below, which character you want me to do, okay? What character do you want me to do throughout the entire Avengers Infinity War? You can go type in Infinity War, you know which characters are going to be there, and it's got to be someone I haven't drawn yet in Inktober. So no Thor, Hulk, Spider-Man, okay? So none of those. Let me know which character you would like me to draw next. Let me know in the comments below, and the winner, I think we'll get the most votes, that's what I will draw for tomorrow, okay? Now, before I leave, what I did want to do with these videos, just to give you guys a little bit more value, is just to answer a question of the day, okay? So a question of the day, anyone, like all of you, if you have any art-related questions or questions about me or any questions at all, I'd like to end my videos with answering a question of the day. So let me also know your question, what question you would like me to answer in the comments below. And today, I'm looking back at my just the recent videos, I didn't really have that many questions that I didn't answer in my James Ray show. So once again, go check out the James Ray show. So one topic I did want to discuss, and this is actually the topic of my next podcast, okay? So not the one coming out today. I'm having a podcast coming out today, but my podcast that's coming out next week revolves all about earning a living as an artist. So I actually talk about money. I talk about how much it earns compared to comic book artists and video game artists to film artists, like the differences in pay grade and all of that stuff. I talk about that in next week's podcast. You gotta wait for that. Also look out for today's podcast. Should be coming out soon. Today I talk about putting together my Star Wars piece and about goals. Okay, so check that out. Me and my buddy Jonathan Carnation, check that out. But that did bring about one topic I did want to touch briefly on in this particular video. And that is the whole point about working for free, okay? Working for free. I did have a video on this with my How to Become a Comic Book Artist series, and I just wanted to talk about my theories about working for free, because that is a little taboo subject, and a lot of artists will tell you never, ever, ever, ever work for free. When is it appropriate to work for free? So just quickly, and I get into this in depth in next week's podcast, but right off the bat, when would I personally work for free? Especially when you are starting out as an artist, when you're starting out as the artist, it's hard. It's very, very hard to get noticed. It's very, very hard to get work. It's very, very hard to get your foot in the door, especially if you're trying to get into something like comic books. It's really, really tough, okay? Now, there are some things that will help you get those jobs, whether it be in comics, whether that be in concept art, and my computer agrees with me. And what that is experience. It all boils down to experience, and the experience you have that will help employers, publishers, writers, video game companies determine whether you are valuable enough for them to hire on. Okay, so when do you work for free? Okay, first of all, when do you work for free for someone? In comics, and I mentioned this before, the only time I would work for someone else in comics is either, number one, they were a well-established writer. Okay, so they have a name as a writer, and they're just trying to get, you know, a project off the ground. You're helping them out. If they are a well-established writer, they are a very known writer, that's a case I would work for free. Number two, if there was a guarantee, an absolute guarantee, I know this book is going to be published. Because if you go check out my interview with John Barber, he talks about when he was working as an editor in Marvel, how important it was, how valuable it was to actually have an actual paper comic book in his hand when looking for a particular artist. So that would be another situation where I would consider working for free. Same thing when it comes to concept art. If I know this project will actually happen, or this project will be possibly produced, and I know, there's a chance of that, then I would possibly consider working for free. Okay, so there's all these artists telling you not to work for free. However, if it will get you that promotion, especially if you're starting out, you know. It is what it is at that time. You know, you have to do some of these small projects. I even talk about working for free for influencers, all that. I will discuss that in the podcast. For example, one thing I didn't touch upon that, like, for example, if I remember before for a Mayweather fight, they had this contest about making a movie poster or something like that, like some sort of advertisement or logo, and they opened it up and they didn't give a money prize. And there's a promotion, and everyone hated that. Everyone hated artists, like, you gotta pay your artist. And in all honesty, they do. They gotta pay the artist. But if you're just starting out, what were the chances you were gonna get that job in the first place? None. Absolutely none. So why don't you try? You never know, right? There was that one guy who did the short, and here's a great example. There was the one guy who did the short, I believe it was a Conjuring, they wanted directors to make a Conjuring short that would be in the vein of The Conjuring, right? A short film. And then people were looking through the rules and regulations, and they noticed that what would happen is the company that owns The Conjuring, I can't think about it in the top of my head, they would get, you know, all the royalties, right? And they would just pay the director $50. Okay? On the surface, that seems pretty bad. It does, right? Now, if that, you know, if someone said that's your pay for us, of course most people would turn it down. However, with this particular contest, the guy who won, and the video was apparently really, really good, what he did. People are commenting, hey, I hope you enjoy your $50. And he goes, yeah, I'll enjoy the $50. I'll also enjoy the fact that three different Hollywood agents called me the next morning. I'll enjoy the fact that these two Hollywood studios want to work with me. So sometimes, especially when you're starting out, don't just look at the short term when it comes to trying to find, you know, to getting paid. One thing I would say, if you're not willing to work with anyone else, that's totally fine. That's up to you, for free, I mean. If you're not willing to work for free, then at the very, very least, work for free for yourself, okay? Draw for yourself, whether that means draw your own comic book. Do concept designs of your own IP or your own characters, or do that work for yourself and post it on Instagram. YouTube, whatever, and that will help you along the way, okay? I get into more in depth about all of this, about when I would work for free, all of that, and actual pay in next week's podcast, where I talk about all of this. That is the Money Podcast. In the meantime, check out today's podcast that should be coming out very soon, maybe even by the time this video is out, those podcasts will be up. Check that out. But thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed my Inktober drawing. That was a lot of fun, but thank you guys so much. Let me know your question. What question of the day you would like me to answer down below. Also, let me know down below which character from Infinity War you want me to draw tomorrow. I'm here to listen to you as long as you are here to watch me draw. So thank you so much for that. Follow me on all social media, all down below. And if you are new here, you looked around, you like what you see, if you wouldn't mind hitting that subscribe button, well, I will be your friend for life. My name is James. I am the Box Office Artist. I'm here to say keep drawing, and I'll see you all tomorrow.